Sapulpa, Oklahoma, party people. Gotta bring this trailer in for repairs. You know, this is the trailer that had the air leak in it. I'll show you what we were, me and the mechanic were able to determine at the, I took it to the first shop. They claimed to have fixed it, the air leak. Woke up the next morning and did my pre-trip, and again, the same air leak came up. I know where I am, babe, but so we're done with you again. And so I took it to the second shop, and they claimed to, Okay, I don't know where I'm at. I think it's the next one. My bad. So what happens is, we don't know what's wrong with it. Drive it around the lot to bring it back and see if your little light's still on, this and that. The light was still on. And so we couldn't get that box open. The guy goes, let me get a screwdriver. While he was looking for a screwdriver, took my key out and pried open that latch and opened up that box. And I'll show you that. And that's where we discovered. Yeah, this is it, right? Yeah. I haven't been here in a while, my bad. That's where we discovered the regulator, or it could be like a little manifold in there, was leaking. And so what we did was pump the air tires up and put the four ways on. And pump the tires up and shut off the valve to lock so the air tires cannot leak. And then you just check your air pressure and the tires the conventional way. Does that make sense? And so that's what we had to do that way. So let me talk to the guy checks all your equipment before you come in. And so we'll check in. On duty. And if he has any permits for me or anything like that, we'll get our permit book updated. Where is he? Where'd he go? All right, party people, I'm gonna drop the trailer here in the yard for repairs. I'm gonna show you what we determined. I don't wanna get too close, but I wanna be parallel. Let's see, right about there. It's not too bad. Try to judge where the front of that trailer and front of my trailer are matching. I think that's gonna be all right about there. Let's go see how we did. See how close we got. I'm gonna push the red one in. I wanna show you something real quick. Let's go back and look at it. Where's my thing at? Okay. So like I said, I took it to the second shop and they couldn't get this, they didn't even bother looking in here because see how that latch runs into that junction? So I was able to use the key to pry this open. Screwdriver would be a lot easier. Let's see. Oh, I almost had it. Come on. Oh. Babe, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. When I get one side down, I can't get the other side down. All right, let's do one side at a time. Okay. Oh. Okay, I got that one. Get this side. There it is. So now, what's leaking is this regulator. This is the regulator up here, I believe. It's electronically regulated, and I believe this is called the manifold. That's what I'm calling it. And when you open it up, the valve, you can hear it leaking. And so we just close it off. Okay, so there you go. It's closed off right now, turned off. When it's in line, it's open. When it's like that, it's turned off. And what happened is we have to check. It's illegal to run this way as long as it's not leaking. This is a regulator that pumps up the tires, in other words. To check the tires, we have to go We have to check them the conventional way every morning. I'm just going to give you a quick example. I'm jumping the trailer here for work. They're going to fix that. But here's how you check your... Here's the a little bit complicated. You got to... takes a few more extra time. But if you had a low tire, you can pull these off here like this. Here's how you check them. Let's check our pressure is 100 pounds. We're good. If you needed to air up your tire, you just air it up right here. And when you're done, you just plug it back in. And repeat the process all the way around. It just takes a little bit extra time to do it, that's all. And you just tighten this back up. Whoop, wasn't started. There we go. Very simple. But like I said, the TA didn't have that box, that regulator. So they just talked to JCT. They said just shut the valve off. Make sure the tires are properly inflated the conventional way. Check them the conventional way. And there you go. That's how you do it. So let's drop it here. Drop the trailer here and go get our load. Pop that back. All right, party people, there you go. That's how you do it.